Welcome to clickmyproject.com. Project title is A Framework for Processing Large-Scale Geospatial and Remote Sensing Data in MapReduce Environment. Now let's consider our abstract. In recent years, distributed data processing has reached many areas of computer science, including geographic and remote sensing information system. With the continuing increasing of data, existing algorithm and the data management needed to be moved to new architecture, which may require a great goal of effort. This paper describes a geospatial data pre-processing framework designed to able to management and processing of spatial and remote sensing data in distributed environment. So the framework is based on the mainstream Hadoop like that MapReduce in open source environment in Hadoop library. The primary design goals of this framework or extensibility and adaptability. So, to enable previously implemented algorithm and existing toolkits to be easily adapted to distributed execution without major effort. So, the plausibilities of the frameworks are demonstrated on remote sensing image processing operations in comparison with the existing solution in the Hadoop environment. So, research show this toolkit provide a much broader possibility to advance geospatial data processing than the currently available solution. Now we are going to discuss about our flow diagram. First of all, the first process is load data set. Here we have to select our data set for the entire process with image. And next process is segmentation. After segmentation process, we have to extract our features. Here we have to features many like that, features 1, 2, 3, etc. And the next process is load image features data. Here we have to load our image and future our data for the entire process. Next process is we have to store our file in Hadoop environment. Here we have to use VATCON for the MapReduce function. And next process is mapping. After mapping, we have to reduce our word count, and finally we have to analyze our data after completing map and reduce process. Next, classifying area. Here we have to classify area like trees or land or seawater or building like that. And then next process is predict result. Here we have to predict our result for the compare output. And next, finally we have to show our result. Finally, we have to run our process on Hadoop. So just click home.java and click run as, run on Hadoop. Then select VM server, then click finish. So operation in progress. And then now we have to get our output. Just a minute. Okay, now we have to get our output. Then click start button. The next frame will be okay. So first we have to select our data set for the entire process. So just click browse. So now click data and select our data image.csv file. Click open. So now we have to get our files for the entire process. Then click load data. When I click load, means our data will be stored into database. Each and every database should be stored in a particular column. So it takes some time because each and every value should be stored in a particular place. So it takes some time. Finally, we get our output. So just a minute. Okay, then now we have to get our good information for our entire process. So next put click button, and now we have to see our data. And if when I click store in HDFS means our file will be stored in Hadoop environment. Here HDFS nothing but Hadoop distributed file system. Okay, and then now our file will be uploaded successfully. Then next click button. The Hadoop is mainly used for MapReduce concept. When I click MapReduce concept means it will be map and reduce in the column. So next we are going to pre-process our data set. So pre-process successfully. Here we have to remove our irrelevant and redundant value from our original data set. So next processes, here we have to selecting our futures. Here we have number of futures are there. So I click future 6. So we have to get our future 6 selection. Then click OK. Then find Euclidean distance. After calculator we have to see our distance, then click next. Then here we have to classify using K-NN future algorithm. Classification will be found. So K-NN future like that. So click PNN. So get value, median value, and invalid value. So find hidden. So here also our hidden layers also help calculator. The next probabilistic neural network, so distance can be calculated. And the next classify the futures and give next. Here we have to classification report. So click KNN future and PNN future, and then the predicted value. So now we have to select our image data from the satellite. The cluster value becomes four types of classification. So click next button. Here we have to see our seawater and next get, and when I get click from this is the satellite image from the whole area of the project. When I click get button means we will get a image from the satellite. So demo is completed. Thank you for watching this video.